a pleasure to see you. A pleasure indeed. I am Gauri, a great sage. In my day, anyway. I'd hoped to ask a favor when one of your ilk came along. A strapping young tarnished, able to cross the Scarlet Swamp of Aeonia. Don't fret. I'll provide fine should you accept. I will teach you the secret of Celia, the town you see there. Ah, then you are willing to lend a hand. I need your help to heal a certain young... Her name is Millicent. You will find her beyond Celia, resting at the church atop the cliff. Stricken. Oh, you found the unalloyed gold needle. As promised, I've detailed the secret of Celia right here. Go on. It's yours. Now let me have a look at the needle. Well, this is a marvel indeed. The work of a true artisan, a meticulous, bold craftsman who grasps the essence of life. Can you give me some time with this? As well made as it is, it won't be much use, snapped. Can you give me as well made? Awaited your return. The needle is repaired. Now it will forestall the rotting sickness, I'm sure. Will you give it to the girl, Millicent? I will reward you in kind. Millicent rests at the church atop the cliff beyond Celia, tended to by the witless pests who worship her. A wretched fate, indeed. The poor girl, she never wished. Do you find it peculiar that I would show such concern for the girl? Well, I'm the one that found her. A mere babe in the swamp, but she is one of my dear daughters. But the rotting sickness erodes one. I doubt that she remembers the first thing about me. Oh, I must be getting old. I didn't always worry so much. Now, all you... She's convalescing in the church. Do so, and you shall receive a handsome rec...
If you are wise, you will leave in me. My flesh writhes with scarlet. You ask that I stab myself with the needle to quell the scarlet rot. But how? Never mind. I've decided I would rather trust you than simply continue to spoil from within. Would you mind averting your eyes for a moment? Well, that was easier than expected. But why do I feel so? I hoped to see you again. My apologies for when last we met. I fainted before I could even thank you. Everything is as you said. Since inserting the needle, the scarlet rot has ceased to writhe. Even the nightmares have abated. And now, though I can scarcely believe it myself, I can move as I please. Not that I could ever truly repay you, but I would like you to have this, by way of thanks. A token, though it is. I'm considering leaving. On a journey with the needle buried in my flesh, I've started to recall my destiny. It's all thanks to you. My name is Millicent. I pray fate. I'm considering leaving. With the needle buried in my destiny. This place felt familiar to me, so I decided to pay a visit, hoping to find someone here, but I've only found emptiness. Perhaps before my departure, I needed someone to say farewell to. Well, I must focus on my journey, for which I have you to thank. I must stay strong. Well, I must folk, I must.
thank you kindly for giving the needle to Millicent. Now she too can begin her journey and stare her fate straight in the eye. You've been a saint through and through. As thanks, I vow to impart to you my knowledge of the lost sorceries of the Salians, descendants of the Eternal. Oh, you noticed, did you? Indeed, Millicent did visit this hovel of a home. It seems the memories eaten away by the rotting sickness yet remain, but faintly. However, she has no need of me anymore. No, she must embark on her journey and stare her fate in the eye. I mustn't impede. As I've aged, I've found the best way to aid the young is to be forgotten.